to see you. Holy, 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 I want to see you. Holy, 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 I want to see you.
Welcome to Galena United Methodist Church. I'm Pastor Katiana, and it's so good to have you with us today. We welcome all, and we practice loving acceptance of each person and respectful discussion of our differences. The community's health and welfare is of great importance to us, and currently all activities, worship, study, group reflection, prayers, and meetings take place using Zoom. We post our gatherings on emails and through Facebook and our website. On May 23rd, we will meet together in Galena at Rec Park. We have reserved a pavilion actually throughout the summer and through September. But we believe that we will be back in our sanctuary mid-summer, if not earlier. We'll keep you posted. If you would like to be placed on our email or mailing list, please drop us a note or call me, Pastor Katiana, at 630-935-3312, and a personal Zoom call is always possible. Blessings.
Local churches provide essential support to their communities, but local churches need support too. That's where the I Give UMC campaign can help. Begin by making a gift to your church in honor or memory of someone who has made a difference to you. Then post on social media. Share a video about the person that's special to you, or a photo of their impact on your life. And encourage others to join you. Ask them to make a gift and social media post of their own. All of the resources you need to participate as an individual or to launch a campaign in support of your church are available online. Join the celebrations planned throughout the year, as well as others on your calendar. Thank you for supporting your local church.
As Jesus prepares to leave the disciples, he opens their minds and blesses them. After he ascends, they return to Jerusalem with great joy and a desire for continually worshiping and blessing God in the temple. What happens when the eyes of our hearts are enlightened?
Dare to dance with dreamers, sing their song. Dare to dance their stories, sing out strong. Dare to dance with freedom your whole life long. Dare to dance again.
Dancing changes us. It transforms us and brings us to life, awakens our senses. Imagine the dreams and the heartbeat and the life stirring in Jesus and his disciples as he readied them for this next chapter of ministry. As we wait for the Spirit with hope, we celebrate with abandon because we have no other ruler than the one who reigns with love and justice.
Dare to dance with dreamers, sing their song. Dare to dance their stories, sing out strong. Dare to dance with freedom your whole life long. Dare to dance again.
This is the call. Ready yourselves for new life. We lift up our heads to meet the day. Get ready to be the hands and feet of Jesus in this world. We fortify our hearts with compassion and action. Even when rain sets in, open those umbrellas of gratitude and set out anyway. For we are called to dance again.
To our serving King. Hallelujah. Holy One, Justice Seeker, Lover of Creation, help us to put our dancy shoes on so that we can be the hands and feet of Jesus. Come and dance with us, engage with us as we seek you, so that we can be risen with Christ and in Christ. Be with us now, we pray. Amen. The peace of the risen Christ is with you, and also with you. You are invited to turn to the people around you and wave as a sign of graceful greetings today.
Dare to dance with dreamers, sing their song. Dare to dance their story, sing out strong. Dare to dance with freedom your whole life long. Dare to dance again.
Every week we've been talking about people who had a dream to live out. It might surprise you that this week that the dreamer is Jesus. Jesus had dreams of a better world and a better life for those in his community. You see, even in houses of worship in Jesus' day, some people thought they were better than others. They called some people unclean and didn't include women in their community in the same way they included men. But Jesus had a dream. We know this because he reached out to include everyone, especially those who were being treated badly or excluded. He touched sick people and immigrants. He talked with and made friends with women. All of those things were unheard of. But Jesus had a dream. He called it the kingdom of God. In the kingdom of God, in the dream of Jesus, neighbors would go out of their way to help others, especially those who were strangers, who were suffering in some way. If somebody was left out, Jesus showed us that we needed to reach out to them. Even though Jesus lived here on earth a long time ago, when he left, he said that we were to be his presence in the world. So we take on his dream. Our colorful umbrellas are a sign of joy and hope, even on rainy days. Today we'll add a phrase from Jesus' dream on our prayer umbrella. Welcome to all. Let's offer a repeat after me prayer. We offer thanks.
We offer thanks.
For dreamers true.
For dreamers true.
For all they are.
For all they are.
And all they do.
And all they do.
Let us become.
Let us become.
Dreamers too.
Dreamers too.
And bring new life.
And bring new life.
To me. And
to
you.
Me and you.
Amen.
Amen.
Clap your hands, all you peoples. Shout to God with loud songs of joy. The Lord the Most High is awesome, a great sovereign over all the earth. God subdued peoples under us and nations under our feet. God chose our heritage for us, the pride of Jacob whom he loves. God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our sovereign, sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth. Sing praises with a psalm. Then Jesus said to them, these are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I am sending upon you what Abba, God, proclaimed. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high. Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they were continually in the temple blessing God. May God empower the word in our hearing.
Let us pray. Loving God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts find their place in you, O God, our strength. Amen. This week, 40 days after Easter, we celebrate Ascension Sunday, and next week we celebrate Pentecost 50 days after Easter, the end of Weeks of Weeks, or as the Hebrew holiday is often called, the Festival of Weeks. Luke closes his gospel where it begins and opens his sequel, Acts, with this story of the Ascension. Both are in the temple. And we end at the same place, but everything has changed in those intervening 3 or 4 years. Time does that, doesn't it? But we don't normally notice the effects of time unless we step back and reflect. Until we open our eyes to see the big picture or the larger story unfolding. But sometimes it isn't the passage of time that changes our perspective as much as it is the addition of new information. It's like we suddenly receive a final piece of a puzzle and it suddenly all makes sense. Fictional mysteries, as well as real-life investigators, spend their time looking for these lost pieces of information that open our minds to see the full picture more clearly. Now, have you ever stayed up late because you were engrossed in a book or a movie that kept revealing new pieces of information and you wanted to know how the story would end or how it would develop? I do that with mysteries, wanting to know how the pieces of the puzzle finally come together in the actions of the characters in the story. Maybe you're familiar with TED conferences or TED Talks. TED, which is an acronym for Technology, Entertainment, and Design, is an invitation-only event for key leaders in business, science, and academia. They invite speakers from a wide range of expertise to provoke thought and discussion. The TED conferences, or TED Talks, began in 1984, and many of the presentations are now posted on the internet for a wider audience to enjoy. One of the speakers a few years ago was Catherine Schultz, who talked about the power and importance of being wrong. Now, she is a self-proclaimed wrongologist. She begins her talk by telling of a road trip that she and her friend took when she was in college. She was a city person who was traveling across the country for the first time. At one point, she asked her friend about the signs with Chinese characters on them. Now, she felt foolish asking the question after she found out what it was: a picnic table. But at the time, she thought she was right. Thinking you are right when you are shown to be wrong, she says, leads to an emotional dilemma that often keeps us from learning the truth unless we begin to value the idea that we might be wrong. The disciples, like their contemporaries, had been hoping for a king to restore the throne of David. They had hoped that God would send someone to conquer the Romans and claim their rightful place. They based their hope on the scriptures they read each week, stories of promises God made to the people of Israel for hundreds, even thousands of years. They went to the temple and prayed for a redeemer to come and fulfill their hopes and dreams. Like Catherine Schultz, they thought they were right. When Jesus first appeared, many of the followers thought he was the man God had sent to fulfill the scripture. They followed him into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday, expecting a confrontation with Rome. But the week ended in his death. To many, it was a failed dream. Even when Jesus returned from the dead, they weren't sure what that meant because he didn't come waving his sword. It was contrary to what they had hoped for, and it conflicted to the way they had read the scriptures. They knew what the scriptures said. So many of them refused to believe that the story was true. Now, it's interesting how often we discount the evidence rather than change our minds about things when the last piece of data is revealed. They didn't want to admit that they were wrong because they were so certain they had been right. But then Luke tells us that Jesus opened their minds. He showed them other scriptures, passages they had overlooked, something they had missed. He invited them to see, to look with new eyes. Now, 40 days ago, we celebrated Easter, and 40 days before that, we were telling the story of the Transfiguration. These two stories, the Transfiguration and the Ascension of Jesus, serve like bookends on either side of Easter, giving us a place, a time, and a place to reflect on the meaning of Easter and finding an appropriate response. In the earlier story, Moses and Elijah speak to Jesus. Now Jesus tells us that Moses and Elijah will speak to us through the pages of Scripture. When we read the Scripture with Easter eyes, we will see that the resurrection was a fulfillment of God's possibility. And in response to this new understanding of Scripture, Luke tells us that the people return to the temple to bless God. They go back to the beginning of the story, only now they are changed. They no longer pray to overthrow the Roman oppressors, but they pray instead for renewed hearts, hearts filled with joy. They wait for power to fall on them so they can proclaim the story of salvation or transformation in Christ to the world. Now, the book of Acts doesn't end in Jerusalem where it began. Instead, Luke ends the story in Rome, where we find Paul quote from Acts 28, proclaiming the kingdom of God and teaching about the Lord Jesus Christ with all boldness and without hindrance. The story has changed. So has Paul. So has Peter. They thought they were right, but they only saw a part of the picture. They had to repent, to turn around. They had to change the way they understood both the scripture and their lives in order to live as faithful followers of Jesus. Now, when do I think I have it right? Could it be that I'm only seeing part of the picture too? Of what things do I need to repent? Questions for all of us. Repentance is a word we use to talk about turning around or changing our lives. It's often used as if it were a one-time expression. I was walking south, now I'm walking north. I have repented. We often refer to repentance in the context of wrongdoing. Rarely do we think of repentance in the terms of wrong thinking. But repentance is really a mindset that allows us to see the sin or separations in our lives and change, but not at once, but continually. It is to see the places where we have acted wrongly and find new ways to act. It's being able to see the times when we have spoken what we thought was true and learned it was not. Repentance is to step back and read the scriptures with open minds about what God might be saying, rather than relying on what we always thought God was saying in the past. Now, it's an unsettling way to live. But that's what it means to be an Easter people. It's like a bumper sticker that said, brains are like umbrellas. They work better when open. Now, I know there's a tension that exists between listening to the voice of God in times of change and standing firm when change is proposed. We like to think we're right, so we don't need to change our minds. But the disciples thought they were right too. Throughout the scripture, there are stories of people who thought they were right, so they refused to listen for the voice of God. We read how the people of Israel refused to listen to Jeremiah when he told them to stay in Jerusalem. They fled to Egypt because they thought Jeremiah was wrong. In much the same way, Peter didn't want to welcome Gentiles into the community of faith, but God helped him see that he was wrong. The church also was reluctant to let Paul be involved in evangelism, but Barnabas helped them see what God was doing in the world. Not all change is good, and not all change is right. But if we close our minds, God may not be able to speak to us or influence our actions. Jesus ascends into heaven. He leaves us with the scriptures that are to be read under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit works through us. What happens when the eyes of our hearts are enlightened? We know the hope to which we have been called. May we continue our dance with the Spirit, and may our interpretation of Scripture, as well as our actions and our activities, always bring glory to God, the one who reigns with love, joy, and justice. Watch with me now our Dare to Dance video, and let us continue to celebrate the Spirit's movement in and through us. Thanks be to God.
Londoloze uhambe nami zungangishila na Jerusalema ikhaya lami
Actually, that dance, it's a South African dance. It's a dance that comes from South Africa. That's why we dance at weddings. So what happened is that there's these guys from Angola who saw the choreography, and then they started this movement whereby they started dancing to the song, holding plates with food inside. And they started doing the dance also. So the video just went viral. The song Jerusalem, it's a song that I actually made a beat first last year, late 2019. I made a beat, and then after making that beat, it was so spiritual. I remember I kept on listening to it again and again and again, also trying to identify a vocalist that I can feature, because I'm a DJ, I'm a producer, I'm a DJ. And then in my mind it came my sister Nomcebo, the one I featured on the song. And then I remember I called her, she came to the studio, we sat down together in the studio, I played to her, and I told her that I want this song to be as more spiritual as it can. And then we just laid down ideas. And then this Jerusalem, Ekayal, it just came out of nowhere while we're chilling. And we're like, is it fine? Yes, it's fine. Let's put it. And then we put it, we recorded it. And then from there, we just started loving it. Jerusalem, Ekayal, me. Actually, it means Jerusalem, it means my home. And Ilondo Loze means please go with me, please protect me, you know. And then Ohambe Nami means please protect, go with me and protect me, and don't leave me behind, because Jerusalem is my home. The success is so amazing, it's above my imagination, to be honest. I never thought the song will catch everyone's attention, all parts of the world, to be honest. I was just making a song in the studio, just trying to release a single of mine. Like, I never even thought of other countries. I never thought that my people would be dancing to my song in United States of America, in France, in Portugal, Italy, and so forth. So like, I just made a song. Relaxing, but then the success of the song is above my imagination, and then for that I always thank God, because you know, it's a beautiful work that also has done to me. It's taking this song to the next level, you know, because now the song it's everywhere in the world. The Jerusalem dance, it's taking over the world.
Teach me to dance to the beat of your heart. Teach me to move in the power of your spirit. Teach me to move in the light of your presence. Teach me to dance to the beat of your heart.
O God, we give you thanks for the beauty of the world and all its diversity. We give you thanks that we are here together. We come with praise and celebration and hope for renewal. We give thanks for believers everywhere, for that great cloud of witnesses that have gone before us. Let us pray together. May our gratitude to you fill our days. We need your healing, O Holy One, for our troubled planet, for our nation, for all who are struggling in body, mind, relationship, and spirit. We remember those who are suffering. May your presence be known to each of us at the point of our need. We lift our hurts, our disappointments, our hopes, and our dreams. We come seeking guidance for decisions about our relationships. We come with concerns about our health or the health of others. We come in grief about the losses in our lives. Help us sort out the different influences and opportunities in our lives as we strive to live for you. We pray that we will be numbered among the blessed and that we may be a blessing to others. We pray that we may be among those who are poor in spirit, those who are hunger and those who thirst for righteousness, those who show mercy, the pure in heart and the peacemakers. We know what is required of us and we pray in faith in your prayer and in your power, in hope for your kingdom or kingdom, and in love for one another. Let us pray together. Come, O God, and restore our lives.
Teach me to pray in the power of Easter, following Christ in a life resurrected. Teach me to act with compassion and justice. Teach me to dance with the beat of your heart.
Be with each of us now, O God. And may the dance of your spirit ever call us to engage with you and with the needs around us. Lead us, guide us, surround us, fill us. Together let us pray. Come, Holy Spirit, come. O God, lead us in your prayer, the Lord's Prayer, the prayer of Jesus. In whatever language or form that is in our heart, or we may use this prayer of the Methodist tradition. Our Father, Mother God, you who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Teach me to love with your heart of compassion. Teach me to trust in the word of your promise. Teach me to hope in the day of your coming. Teach me to dance to the beat of your heart.
Next week is the last week of our Easter season series. For this season ends with Pentecost, when the flames of the Spirit dance within all people. We are so grateful for all the ways in which you have continued throughout this difficult time of being separated. You have continued to support and give life and movement to the ministries of this church. You are the hands and feet of Christ now in the world. Let us receive our offering.
We encourage you to donate by mail or electronic giving through your bank. You may also donate on our website at galenaumc.org or on our Facebook page. Your donation enables us to reach out to our community and beyond as the body of Christ prayerfully in action. Our change for the better goes to Galena ARC, the Art and Rec Center. The ARC has provided our community and surrounding areas with 45 years of community involvement through art classes, sports, recreation, fitness, childcare, and education. To learn more about Galena ARC, please visit their website at galenaarc.org.
Hey, good morning, everybody. My name is Dave Decker. I'm the Executive Director of the Galena ARC. We're going to do a little building tour today. Welcome to our preschool wing. Come on, follow me in. Down the hallway here, we're going to swing in and look into our three-year-old room. Sneak in here. Getting ready for the pledge this morning.
Good job, Louie. our pledge. So Tyson, you stand up. And Reed, you stand up.
The poet Rumi invites us with these words. Dance when you're broken open. Dance if you've torn the bandage off. Dance in the middle of the fighting. Dance in your blood. Dance when you're perfectly free. May it be so as we go in peace. And may the loving God, the risen Christ, and the dancing spirit fill you with all you need for the days ahead. And all the people said, Amen.
Thank you. let us sing this song for the turning of the world, that we may turn as one. With every voice, every song, we will move this world along, and our lives will feel the echo of our turning. With every voice, with every song, we will move this world along. With every voice, every song, we will move this world along, and our lives will feel the echo of our turning. Let us sing this song for the healing of the world, that we may heal as one. With every voice, every song, we will move this world along, and our lives will feel the echo of our healing. With every voice, with every song, we will move this world along. With every voice, every song, we will move this world along, and our lives will feel the echo of our healing. Let us sing this song for the loving of the world, that we may love as one. With every voice, every song, we will move this world along, and our lives will feel the echo of our healing.